The following is a presentation of Hockey Night in Canada in association with the NHL and Sportsnet.
Oh, Canada, home to some of my favorite fans on the planet. But right now, it's Saturday night, and this is Hockey Night in Canada. Yes!
The incredible Billy Idol Rebel Yell. Kelly Rudy, whose favorite song?
Brent Sutter. He would sing it all the time. It was hilarious.
What are the odds he'd own the Red Deer Rebels?
Well, there you go, right?
And he'd beat your Medicine Hat Tigers. Solid
twice goal. Already.
Yeah.
Chris, Craig, and Kyle are at that game. John Bartlett, Gary Galley, Sean McKenzie in the nation's capital. Harnerine Singh, Louis DeBrusque, and Scott Oak will be at the game in Calgary tonight, and John Shorthouse, Dave Tomlinson, Dan Murphy, your Vancouver crew has been dispatched to Hollywood, where there's a Hollywood star for the great Billy Idol.
Dream team there, dream team.
It is the dream team, and you're a part of it, Kevin. Presented by Rogers. It's Hockey Night in Canada. Kevin Kelly and Jennifer. I want to start with a quick story about two guys born on November 30th who had the proverbial writing on the wall dictate their careers. First of all, Cody Golubeff, a neighbor in Oakville, Ontario, he wrote on his bedroom wall when he was in grade school, make it to the NHL. And he had a fantastic career at Wisconsin. He did make it to the NHL.
McKenzie, the point.
Golubeff scores his first NHL goal. Shot for the right point.
Not only did Cody make it to the NHL, he played for the Ottawa Senators, of course. He played for Canada several times. A Spengler Cup, this is 2009 when he won that amazing World Junior gold. He won a podium position at the Pyeongchang Olympic Games. Cody Golubeff. Mom and Dad, Peter and Laura, didn't paint that over until just a year ago when they were thinking of selling the house. So it was a favorite thing in their home. Thank you, Laura, for the photograph of Cody's amazing script. Now, the other proverbial writing on the wall was actually from a teacher. There was this chap in England who was very good at school, but like you, Kevin, he was full of mischief and easily bored.
I can relate.
The teacher sent a report card home when he was in grade 3 to his mom, said, William is idle in class. William, idle. You see where this is going?
Yes, I do.
That, of course, became the great Billy Idol, who opens his tour in Canada here on July the 30th, from cover of the Rolling Stone to Hollywood Walk of Fame. Unbelievable. Still making the grade. Billy Idol. So they say you can't write this stuff. Yes, you can, or some teacher will for you. Let's get it to Kyle Bukauskas at Bell Center in Montreal. Kyle.
Kairanis, the return of Mitch Marner for the Maple Leafs. No Caden Gooley or Arbor Jacki for the Canadiens, who will collectively attempt to keep Auston Matthews at 63 goals on the season. The last time the number 63 was associated with Matthews, that was his jersey number at his very first development camp with the Leafs almost 8 years ago. He has made Leaf fans feel all sorts of emotions in the time since, including happy tears, as we saw in warm-ups just a moment ago. How about that from that young fan? Isn't that beautiful joy? Cole Caulfield followed in the footsteps of Matthews as a goal-scoring phenom at the U.S. Development Program years ago. Speaking of beautiful, doesn't his hands look ready for this one here tonight? This, the final Saturday night in Montreal of the season. Sean McKenzie, down the 40 in the 4:17 to you in Ottawa.
Well, Kyle, there are a lot of ways to describe the Ottawa Senators season, but this series of events might do the job best. Early February, Panthers-Senators, Anton Lundell beats Jonas Korpisalo from what appears to be an impossible angle. This past Thursday, Panthers-Sens, Anton Lundell beats Jonas Korpisalo from what appears to be an impossible angle. Yes, bad things that really should only happen once keep happening to the Ottawa Senators, like their 6-0 loss to the Panthers on Thursday night that left their captain less and pleased.
I mean, not much needs to be said. That was embarrassing.
Brady went on to say that this team now has to play for pride. They have to play for the fans. So it's fitting, Ron, that tonight is Fan Appreciation Night here in Ottawa.
Oh, Sean, later on we'll talk about captains. 24 years old, Brady Tkachuk, 24 years old, Nick Suzuki, but not now. We'll do that later in the show. How about them?
Okay, we've all been embarrassed, and it's how you rebound from that, right? So, unfortunately, they only have 7 games left, Ottawa, and 5 of them are on the road. I'd like to see them go 4-3 in that stretch.
Gooley and Jacki out, but what a privilege to have Kovacevic join in with Barron, too, another stud young defenseman. So for them, I'm feeling, okay, Toronto has highly explosive offensive. Keep them intact and feel good about your defensive game.
And for Toronto, right, exciting that Marner's back. And in terms of their offensive approach, 3 pretty balanced lines for their top 3 lines. This time of the season, it's about finding your game. And through adversity, you know, Domi, McMahon, Bertuzzi, they found their game. Collectively trying to do so.
Bertuzzi's 400th game in the NHL tonight. All right, you can feel the playoffs just around the corner. There are 21 teams still vying for the final playoff positions. In the midnight hour, they'll be crying more, more, more.